மரியாதை குறிய தமிழ்நாட்டின் ஆளுநர் திரு பன்வாரிலால் புரோஹித் அவர்களே, தமிழ்நாட்டின் முதலமைச்சர் ஸ்ரீ திரு எடப்பாடி பழனிசாமி அவர்களே, தமிழ்நாட்டின் துணை முதல்வர் திரு ஓ பன்னீர்செல்வம் அவர்களே, தமிழ்நாட்டின் சபாநாயகர் திரு தன்பால் அவர்களே, சென்னை பாரதிய வித்யா பவன் தலைவர் திரு என் ரவி அவர்களே, சென்னை பாரதிய வித்யா பவனின் இயக்குனர் திரு கே என் ராமசுவாமி அவர்களே, அனைவருக்கும் மறை வணக்கம். இந்திய தாயின் சிறப்புமிக்க புதல்வர்களில் ஒருவரான நேதாஜி சுபாஷ் சந்திரபோஸின் புருவச்சிலை திறந்து வைப்பதில் நான் மிகுந்த மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகிறேன். எனக்கு இரத்தத்தை தாருங்கள், உங்களுக்கு நான் சுதந்திரம் தருகிறேன் என்ற சுபாஷ் சந்திரபோஸின் வார்த்தைகள் நாட்டின் விடுதலைக்காக போராடிய அனைத்து மக்களுக்கும் உத்வேகத்தை அளித்தது. நேதாஜி இன்னமும் நமது இதயங்களில் வாழ்ந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார். ஐ ஆம் ரியலி வெரி ஹாப்பி அண்ட் ஃபீல் ப்ரிவிலேஜ்ட் டு அன்வேல் திஸ் கிரேட் ஸ்டாச்சு ஆஃப் த கிரேட் சன் ஆஃப் திஸ் கிரேட் கண்ட்ரி. அண்ட் டுடே இஸ் ஹிஸ் பர்த்டே. On the eve of the birthday of this great son, I salute him on behalf of the nation for doing whatever was possible at the time to get freedom to our motherland. And I also would like to compliment the Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu for taking initiative for erecting this statue at a right place today. Along with Mahatma Gandhi and Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Sri Subhash Chandra Bose also is here to inspire us. I am pleased to unveil this statue. One of the most illustrious sons of Mother India, his clarion call of "Give me blood and I shall give you freedom" inspired millions to fight for the nation. He still lives in our hearts. We in India are the inheritors of the legacy of a great civilization that is more than 5,000 years old and had faced several upheavals and tumultuous movements throughout the history. A major landmark in the modern history of our country is the gaining of independence from the British rule. Given the riches of our motherland, many had set their eyes on our country. From the Huns to the English, our freedom struggle was marked by a variety of philosophies, thoughts and approaches. It was a banquet of individuals and collective actions ranging from peaceful satyagraha to more organized resistance. As the struggle was still to acquire force, momentum and mass acknowledgement, Gandhiji returned to India in 1915 and gave it a direction and the collective identity. Even as Gandhiji was turning ahimsa, non-violence, into a powerful weapon of our struggle, the likes of Bhagat Singh continued with their efforts to unsettle British in India. Netaji was another leader who had left an indelible imprint on the freedom struggle. He had stirred the imagination of millions of countrymen through his thoughts, words and deeds. Sri Subhash Chandra Bose, or Netaji as he is fondly known as, is one of the most revered freedom fighters of India. His charismatic personality made him a natural leader, especially among the youth. Sri Subhash Chandra Bose was the son of a wealthy and a prominent Bengali lawyer. In his youth, he was deeply influenced by Swami Vivekananda's teachings and was known for his patriotic zeal. He studied at the prestigious President's College, Calcutta, from which he was expelled for nationalistic activities in 1916. He later graduated from the Scottish Church's College and went to London, where he passed the Indian Civil Service examination in 1920. However, he has resigned from the coveted service in April 1921 and hurried back to India as the struggle for independence gathered momentum. Sri Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose joined the non-cooperation movement started by Mahatma Gandhi and became a youth educator, journalist and commandant of the Volunteers of Bengal. He was arrested and jailed several times and deported for his nationalist activities. In 1938, Netaji was elected President of the Indian National Congress, formed a National Planning Committee, which formulated a policy of broad industrialization at that time. Although he was supportive of Mahatma Gandhi's ideas initially, the two leaders gradually drifted apart. Netaji, along with the younger group of leaders, wanted complete self-rule and without any compromise for India, whereas the older, more moderate leadership was in favor of a dominion status for India within the British rule initially. Although Gandhiji was not in favor of Netaji's militant approach, he respected him and once referred to him as the patriot of patriots. This is what Mahatma Gandhi called Subhash Chandra Bose, patriot of patriots. Netaji founded the All India Forward Bloc in a bid to unify more radical elements in the struggle for independence, but was again incarcerated in 1940. He refused to remain in prison at this crucial period of India's history and went on to fast and to death. The British government had to relent and was forced to release him. Inspired by Subhash Chandra Bose, Azad Hind, an Indian provincial government was formed by an Indian nationalist in exile in 1943 in Singapore. With the support of Japan, Subhash Chandra Bose also took leadership of the Azad Hind force. On 6th November 1943, the then Prime Minister of Japan has declared in the Tokyo Assembly of Greater East Asiatic Nations that Andaman and Nicobar Islands would be transferred to the provisional government of Azad Hind. The Japanese imperial forces were in occupation of those islands from 23rd March 1943 during the World War. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose unfurled the tricolor in Port Blair on 30th December 1943 and declared Andaman Nicobar Islands to be the first Indian territory to be freed from British Raj. Netaji was the supreme commander of Azad Hind Force and head of the state of the provincial government of Azad Hind. Recently I had an occasion to visit Andaman Nicobar and I see the island there, and also a memorial erected where Subhash Chandra Bose ji has unfurled Indian national flag in 1943. Let me now touch upon the connection of the people of this state, Tamil Nadu, with the Indian National Army. As you are all aware, if there was one individual instrumental in establishing Sri Subhash Chandra Bose's strong presence in Tamil imagination, it has got to Pasumpan Muthu Ramalinga Theva. He was an influential leader and a close confidant of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. He was also one of the founding pillars of Forward Bloc and played an instrumental role in mobilizing huge support for Indian National Army. He also launched a Tamil Vikri Netaji at that time. Of course, the dear devotee of Lakshmi Swaminathan, famously known as Captain Lakshmi Sehgal, is well known. She had set up Rani of Jhansi Regiment in the Indian National Army and came to be known as Captain Lakshmi Sehgal. Her husband, Prem Kumar Sehgal, also served in the Indian National Army. Another Tamil Malaysian woman, Janaki Ati Nahappan, Malaysian freedom fighter and social activist, Rasama Bhupalan, also joined Rani of Jhansi Regiment. As 14-year-old, Janaki once attended a rally of Subhash Chandra Bose and so enthralled by his idealism that she handed over expensive earring to Indian National Army as a part of fundraising drive at that time. As I told you, I recently visited the 150-foot high flag mast built to commemorate the 75th anniversary of the unfurling of the national flag by Netaji at Port Blair in Andaman Nicobar. The Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, has unfurled the tricolor at the 150-foot high mast at Port Blair in 2018. Netaji firmly believed in our civilization and its values and its history, which should form the bedrock of our national pride and collective self-confidence. He was spiritual and intellectual genius. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was one of the tallest leaders of Indian struggle for independence. I pay my humble tributes to this great son of India on the occasion of his birth anniversary today. I am also to pay respect today to all the freedom fighters, including Swatantra Veera Damodar Savarkar, who had bravely fought against the British in the face of the most daunting odds Veer Savarkar was given two life sentences and imprisoned for 10 years in the infamous Sillar jail, where he was subject to inhuman treatment. I had an occasion to visit the Sillar jail recently. I wanted to show the Sillar jail to my grandchildren so that they know the background of the freedom movement and the sacrifice made by these great people. And really, I suggest to all the children across the country, not only children, even politicians, particularly MLAs, MPs, please visit once Andaman Nicobar, see the Sardar jail, see the freedom fork, then you will try to understand the fight, the vela, the sacrifice, the dedication and the devotion these great sons of this great country have shown for the country at that time. Two life imprisonments, single cell without a toilet. And this cell is situated in front of the gallows, so that whenever somebody is hanged, you see that and you get demoralized. This is what the Britishers have done. And I have seen that 659 freedom fighters, some of them from Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Bengal, Maharashtra, different provinces, Telugu and other provinces, who are all incarcerated there in that jail, because they have kept that jail because far away from the mainland, you cannot escape, you have to swim oceans to create a psychological depression. That was the plan, the way they were tortured in jail. Horrifying, those are jailers, the way they treated, and they were not even given proper food, proper clothes and punishments. This is horrible, but that's the treatment made out to these great sons of this great country. Some people, maybe lack of knowledge, of adequate knowledge of history, maybe of their own leanings, try to portray Veer Savarkar in a negative sense. They should try to understand the real story. And I was also mentioning about the great struggle organized by Subash Chandra Bose. Imagine those days, going to Germany, Berlin, going to Japan, going to different European countries, mobilizing support as an individual. He was not a, what do you call, a leader of elected here, but still he went around to mobilize support against the British to get freedom, and then going and then forming an army, recruiting 40,000 people, giving them training, and then giving a uniform, a sense of belonging and patriotism. The way Subhash Chandra Bose fought for the freedom of the country by other means to send them out, the Britishers who came here and then ruled us, ruined us, looted us, cheated us, cheated some of our minds also. That's the problem. Some people are suffering even today of the colonial mindset. And unfortunately, after the freedom, we could not rectify the historical mistakes that were there in Indian textbooks. And we were all taught Robert Clive the Great, the man who came here, ruled us, ruined us, tortured us, looted our property, affected our culture, and you call him as Robert Clive the Great. And you don't give that much respect. Unfortunately, our textbooks have not given adequate importance to all the freedom fighters. Taking out their history, that is the need of the hour. It's Subhash Chandra Bose, Sardar, Patel, Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Savarkar and all, okay, but here in Tamil Nadu, as I was telling, first of all, Muthuramaranga Teva, then what about Veerapandiya Kattabomman, V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, Subramanya Bharati, great people. You don't find adequate mention of those people in the Indian history, giving them rightful place. We have neglected these heroes. It is time that we really revisit the history of the country, not to create any new history, but to portray the real history, the sacrifice made by these great sons of this great country. Whether it is Tamil Nadu, whether it is in Andhra Pradesh, Allur, Sitaramaraju, many people like that, they fought the Britishers, Jhansi Lakshmibai and all. So history must be comprehensive. It should really inspire our children about their past, the glory, the sacrifice made so that they also move in that direction. We are a free India now. We must all develop pride in our culture and heritage and respect for these great leaders. Our children must read a proper life. That is what is required. I am of the strong view that we must teach our children about India's history, the glorious struggle of independence, the sacrifice may be made by different people. That is the need of the hour. And we should draw inspiration from their sacrifice and strive to build a strong, inclusive, progressive, peaceful and harmonious nation. My dear sisters and brothers, India has been independent for more than 7 decades now. Certainly, substantial progress has been achieved in all fronts during these decades. But much more needs to be done. Pockets of poverty, illiteracy, inequality, poor infrastructure, poor sanitation, social evils continue to haunt us, and we are paying tributes. This is not to just to erect a statue and garden him. This is to draw inspiration and rededicate ourselves with much more commitment to the cause of the nation. And what is meant by nation? And we say Jai Hind. What does it mean? Hindustan ko Jai Ho. Jai Hind do not mean Jai Ho to one person, one individual, one community. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one nation, one people, one country. All of us, all the people in the country, whether you are a Muslim, whether you are a Christian, whether you are a Jain, you are a Parsi, or you are Sikh, or a, whatever practicing this thing, you are all Indians, people who did not leave this country, who have chosen to stay here in this country. They are all equal citizens. They must all be given equal respect. Anybody doing otherwise, for the people of the country, I am not talking about others, people of the country, you are doing a disservice to the nation. Unfortunately, what we are all seeing is, in the public life, those days, they have taken this as a mission. Of late, the mission is getting reduced, and some populists started making commission, giving remission, and doing omission, and no passion. We must rededicate ourselves to the passion to the country. Country means, again, not the geographical boundary of Kashmir to Kanyakumari. Country means, again, 130 crore people. Men, women, youth, forward, backward, minority, majority, all those welfare. And nobody should starve without food. Nobody should be left without education. Nobody should be left without clothing. We are making progress. We have made progress in 72 years by successive governments, undoubtedly. But these areas here and there, certain areas of discrimination on the basis of gender, on the basis of social background, this is not acceptable at all. So we need to change the mindset of the people and see to it that we all dedicate ourselves to the cause of the nation and its forward march. Every Indian must be empowered with education, health, economic opportunities to unleash his or her inner and creative energies for the individual and common good. As we seek to surmount the contemporary challenges to build a new India, there is so much to draw from the life and struggle of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Netaji means leader. This very word is Netaji. Netrutva karne wale, leader. This is the actual listing at that time. His vision and his nationalistic outlook. Today, India is at the cusp of transformation. It has the largest youth population in the country. 65% are below 35 years. 50% are below 25 years. This youth population will determine India's future. We must channelize the creative energy of this tremendous youth population into creative pursuits of nation building. We must all have constructive mind, not obstructive mind or destructive mind. Construct, not obstruct or destruct. That should be the goal, and we must guide the youngsters properly. After all, we are an independent country, we are a free country. And we have parliamentary democracy. So we should do anything. Any damage to public property is a damage to yourself, to the nation. Any violence is, and silence on the part of others about this violence is also a menace that has caught into public life in certain areas. We must see to it that we follow democratic methods and we follow peaceful methods, and we should treat public property as our personal property, not to amass property, but to protect the property and give wealth to the nation, and also so that you can take care of the health of the nation. This inspiration will come if you go through the life of these great people, their writings, their preachings, all, and then you will get the needed courage and conviction. Subhash Chandra Bose was a man of action as well as thought. To a certain extent, the details of his life are shrouded in mystery. The government has recently declassified all records and files associated with Netaji and made them available to the national archives in India. This is a laudable step. More researchers will now be able to dwell deep into his life and come up with many more meaningful publications on the life story of this great patriot and his relentless struggle for freeing India from the clutches of Britishers. More research to know about the contribution he has made, what has happened to him and all. The government has also opened a Subhash Chandra Bose Museum at the iconic Red Fort to mark the leader's 122nd birth anniversary 2019. Such memorials and symbols such as this statue will keep memory of Netaji alive in the conscience of this great nation. I compliment Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Chennai, for coming forward and sponsoring this statue of Sri Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. What is required today is, as I told you earlier, that we should all rededicate ourselves to the cause of the nation by doing our bit for the cause of the nation. And recently only we have celebrated the anniversary of the Constitution earlier, and now we are going to have it again. We should all rededicate ourselves to the Constitution. And while talking about fundamental rights, we must also perform our fundamental duties. Duties and rights must go hand in hand. You cannot demand a right without doing your duty. By performing your duty, you are protecting the rights of the other person. The other person also, vice versa. Keeping that in mind, the youngsters should dedicate themselves to the cause of the nation building, develop a broad outlook of the nation, and think that we are one nation and one people, and work while keeping individual identity, while keeping regional identity, while keeping the local civilization. We must all adhere to the national ethos. That is my advice to all the youngsters. Thank you very much for this pleasant gathering in the evening today. I once again compliment the governor for taking this initiative, and the chief minister and deputy chief minister and colleagues for making this function a grand success. Nandri, Vanakkam.